Good morning, all of you. Good afternoon, all of you. I hope I'm audible and visible to everyone. Please give me a quick thumbs up. And starting with the today's session, the neat pattern question or the new pattern questions in dermatology. Now, I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your neat PG educator on an academy, and I've myself scored All India rank 261 in my entrance examination. So I will give you the tips and tricks which is required for you all to crack your entrance examination. Okay. Now, first of all, about An Academy, this is the best online platform for the preparation of NEET PG. I just want all of you to download the An Academy learning app. On downloading the app, you have to choose the category that is NEET PG. And after choosing the category, you can just access to any of the classes on An Academy. Now, we have two batch courses. One is FMG test and analysis batch course. And the next is INICT batch course. Requesting all my dear students to please become a part of it. And the next is we have two type of subscriptions. One is Plus and another is Iconic. Plus give you an access to live classes, quizzes, batch courses and structure schedules. While Iconic give you an access to the video lectures, question banks, rapid revision courses and handwritten notes. For Plus, you have a 1 year subscription of 24,750 and for Iconic, you have the 1 year subscription of 49,500 rupees. Starting with the first question of the today's session, please give me a thumbs up and answer the question as fast as possible. Please answer the question, which of the following about oral lichen planus is false? Oral LP is most common autoimmune condition of the oral cavity and dental amalgam and stress are the causative factors. Malignant transformation never occurs and the reticular pattern is the most common one. Anyone? Very nice, Ramu. Very well done. Now, please remember, oral lichen planus, it is the most common autoimmune condition of the oral cavity. Absolutely true. Dental amalgam is the causative factor. That is again true. Malignant transformation can occur. And in which variety? Erosive lichen planus. So please remember, in erosive lichen planus, you can see presence of dental amalgam. Please give me a quick thumbs up if you are clear with this. Very, very important. So option number 3 becomes wrong. AD ready, it is option number 3 which is wrong. Rest, all these statements are correct. In which disease do you most commonly see these hypopigmented macules? Anyone? Neurofibromatosis, tuberous sclerosis, Darius disease or Hailey-Hailey disease. In which disease do you most commonly see these hypopigmented macules? Very well done. The correct answer is tuberous sclerosis because these are nothing but ash leaf macules. Okay. Another question. Scarring alopecia is seen in. Where do you see scarring alopecia? Lichen planopilaris, lichen planus pigmentosus, lichen planus pemphigoides or actinic lichen planus? Can you answer this question? Where do you see scarring type of alopecia? Anyone? very nice, all of you. Please remember, scarring alopecia, it is seen specifically in those who have the presence of lichen planus plaque over the scalp. And that variety of lichen planus plaque is called as lichen planopilaris. If this is clear, please give me a quick thumbs up, all of you. It is called as lichen planopilaris. All of you, if you are clear, please give me a quick thumbs up. Am I visible? Please give me a quick thumbs up, all of you. Yes, very nice. So the answer becomes option number one. Venkatesh, Ramu and Sheikh, you are right. Identify the false statement in the management of lichen planus. Please answer this question, Sheikh, Ramu, Venkatesh. Please answer this question, all of you. Which of the following is the false statement? I have not seen anybody's answer till now. Identify the false statement in the management of lichen planus. Very nice. See, I will tell you each and every statement. Systemic therapies are not commonly used. This is true. We mainly treat the patients with a topical treatment, and if at all it is not working, then we will start the patient on oral. Intralesional is indicated. That is again true. You can give intralesional steroids in the patients of hypertrophic lichen planus. And retinoids can be used again in the hypertrophic lichen planus. But please remember, oral steroids are the mainstay. That is the wrong statement. Topical steroids are the mainstay of the treatment. Understood or not? Venkatesh, please give me a thumbs up. Ramu, Venkatesh, Sheikh, everybody give me a thumbs up if you understood. So topical steroid becomes the mainstay of therapy, not the other one. Okay? Very well done, everyone. I hope this becomes very easy now. This disease shown in the image is associated with. So can you tell me, just looking at the image, what is this a clinical picture of? Anyone? The disease shown in the image is associated with thymoma, alopecia areata, myasthenia gravis, or all of the above. Very nice. Ramu, Venkatesh, Sheikh. The disease shown in the image is associated with. The correct answer is all of the above. The disease shown here is lichen planus. And what are the different associations? Please remember this list. What are the different associations of lichen planus? Hepatitis C virus, primary biliary cirrhosis, thymoma, alopecia areata, morphea, dermatomyositis, vitiligo, myasthenia gravis, diabetes mellitus, ulcerative colitis, HIV, renal stone, iron or folate deficiency. So please remember, the correct answer of the question becomes option number 4, that is all of the above. What is the histopathological feature of lichen planus? Sawtoothing, civet bodies, Max Joseph space, or all of the above? Anybody? Please answer the question. Given the histopathological feature of lichen planus, sawtoothing of the epidermis, civet bodies, Max Joseph space, or all of the above. What is the correct answer here? Very well done, all of you. The correct answer is all of the above. Sawtoothing of retae ridges are seen in the patients of lichen planus. Civet bodies are nothing but डिसकेरेटोटिक सॉरी किराइटिनोसाइट्स, मैक्स जोसेफ स्पेस, दीज आर एम्प्टी फोकस, मैक्स जोसेफ स्पेस और एम्प्टी फोकस आर सीन एंड ऑल ऑफ द अबव बिकम्स द करेक्ट आंसर हियर. वेरी नाइस सैम, रामू, वेंकटेश एंड एडी रेडी, यू ऑल आर राइट. नाउ जस्ट लुक एट द इमेज एंड कैन यू टेल मी द हेराल्ड पैच अपीयर्स आफ्टर द क्यूटेनियस लीजन्स ऑफ पिट्रियासिस रोजिया, वेदर दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू और फॉल्स. प्लीज आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन, आई थिंक इट्स अ वेरी ईजी आंसर क्वेश्चन एंड जस्ट मूविंग द इमेज ऑन टू द लेफ्ट फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू, इट बिकम्स बेटर विजुअलाइज नाउ. क्विकली आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन एवरी वन, द हेराल्ड पैच अपीयर्स आफ्टर द क्यूटेनियस लीजन, वॉट इज द करेक्ट आंसर. वेरी नाइस, सो रामू सेज फॉल्स, वेंकटेश से फॉल्स, सैम सेज इट इज अ फॉल्स स्टेटमेंट. Please remember everyone, the correct answer is false because herald patch appears first followed by the cutaneous lesions which are called as daughter patches. Which is called as the daughter patches. So, herald patch appears first, followed by the cutaneous lesions, which is called as the daughter patches. Very well done, all of you. What do you mean by word eczema? Anyone? What do you mean by word eczema? To attack, petty thief, to boil out or out of place. What do you mean by word eczema? Anyone can answer this question? Very nice. The word eczema means to attack, petty thief, to boil out of place. The correct answer is to boil out. Eczema or dermatitis means to boil out because of presence of intercellular edema in the cells of eczema. It tend to come out on the surface, giving it an appearance to boil out. Okay. So Sam and Ramu, the correct answer is option number 3, not option number 2. Can you tell me this is a feature of lichen striatus, chronic eczema, lichen planus or all of the above? What is the correct answer here? This is a feature of lichen striatus, chronic eczema, lichen planus or all of the above. Anybody with the answer? Ramu, Venkatesh, Sam, Edi Reddy, all the other students, I request you to please a little bit quicker in the answers so that we can do a lot of cases or a lot of questions in this session. This is a feature of lichen striatus, chronic eczema, lichen planus or all of the above. Very nice, Sam. The answer is chronic eczema. The picture shows us lichenification. Lichenification is a classical triad of increase in thickness of skin thickness, increase in skin pigment and increase in skin markings. So these three are the features of क्रॉनिक एक्जिमा और लाइकेनिफिकेशंस. ओके, वेसिकल सच एज ग्रेन ऑफ सागो इज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ. Vesicle such as grain of sago is characteristic of linear IgA disease, pomphylix, lymphangioma, circumscriptum or none of the above. Can you answer this question, all of you? Very nice. The correct answer here is pomphylix. Absolutely right. The correct answer here is pomphylix, that is vesicle such as grain of boiled sago is characteristic of pomphylix. Very well done. The next question, this condition occurs in obstructed labor, birth injury, seborrheic dermatitis or none of the above. This condition occurred due to obstructed labor, birth injury, seborrheic dermatitis or none of the above. Can you quickly answer this question, all my dear students? Very nice, Ramu, Sam, very well done all of you. The correct answer is, this is a classical case of seborrheic dermatitis in the infant. Now, usually the seborrheic glands are not active in the infant, but sometimes what happens, because of the stimulation of the seborrheic glands secondary to the maternal hormone, you can see these type of lesions over the scalp of a newborn. Okay, and yes, you are right, this is called as cradle cap appearance. So with this, we are ending our session today. This was a short 15-minute session only today. I request all of you to please be live in the evening session for the image-based questions. We will be doing a lot of images today and it will be around 45-minute sessions to all of you in the evening. So till then, bye-bye, take care. Thank you for your patience listening and please subscribe to the YouTube channel of Unacademy, that is Let's Crack NEET PG. Till then, bye-bye.